Hello dear students, hope you all well. Today we'll start a new chapter, Unit 7, Section C, The Enchanted Shirt. The Enchanted Shirt. What does enchanted means? Enchanted, something that has a magical quality, that is called enchanted. So this shirt maybe have some magical quality, as you can guess by the name of the title of the chapter. So this play is something about same. Let's read it. Phobia is an unreasonable fear of something such as height, water or fire. Are there things that you fear without a reason? Share them with your partner. Now read this play about a king who fears that he is dying, so much so that he even dreams about it. So phobia, you might have heard this word phobia. It means fear. Fear of something, like fear from height, fear from water, fire, anything. So if you have something, you can share with your partner. So this play is about the king who has fear with dying. Let's read the chapter. Characters in the play are Sorphis. It is a king. He is a king. Sorphis is the king name. Ralph, Roger and Billy, they three are the courtiers. Jim is the king attendants, and John, it's a vagabond. Vagabond means a person with no home or means of support, or we can call it wanderer. Dr. Truly, Dr. Sharp, two doctors are there, and then afterwards Dr. 1, Dr. 2, Dr. 3, three physicians are there. Scene 1. Royal Palace, late afternoon, King's office is in his chamber, sleeping soundly and snoring occasionally. The king is sure that he is sick, though his skin is clear and bright. He wonders which illness to pick through. He is a healthy sight. So king was sleeping soundly and snoring in his chamber, and later on he feels that his skin is still his skin is clear and bright, but still he feels that he got some very serious disease, or he is suffering from very serious disease. But there is no symptom of such kind of disease in him. But still he feels that he has very serious disease. Dr. One said to the king, "Ah, your highness, it pains me to bid you farewell." So he said that, "King, I have to say bye to you. You are stricken with cholera." Cause why he has to say bye to him? Cause you are stricken with cholera. Means you are having cholera. You are suffering from cholera. Only heaven can cure you. Soon you'll have to say goodbye to this world. And what cure, he said that only heaven, means only God can cure you with the disease. So I have to say goodbye to you. Or you also have to say goodbye to this world. Now Dr. 2 said, "I'm afraid, Your Majesty, my diagnosis is tuberculosis." Diagnosis means identification of the cause of some illness or any other kind of problem, that is called diagnosis. And tuberculosis is called TB. "If God has mercy on you, he may cure you. Otherwise, there is no hope for you. I too bid you farewell." Dr. 2 also said the same, that you are having tuberculosis and you are going to die soon. Dr. 3, "My sincerest apologies, Your Highness, but I have to agree with my fellow physicians. You are suffering from a rare disease called out of mental focus. We have no pills for that." Dr. 3 has taken out another disease name which nobody had heard, and he said, "You have out of mental focus disease and we do not have any pills for that." So again he said, "I agree with my fellow physicians also. Now you have to say goodbye to this world." Suddenly the king sits up and screams for his attendants and courtier. All of a sudden king got very angry, and he started shouting and calling his attendants and courtiers. Sophies, "Courtiers, attendants, where are you?" Like he is calling in the same way. Roger, "Yes, Your Majesty, here we are at your service." And Jim, "Give Your Highness some water from the silver goblet." So Roger and Jim, they both came, and they were like, "Yes, sir, what happened? We are at your service." And Jim said, "Jim, bring some water for the king in silver goblet." Goblet is a kind of glass. It's a type of drinking glass. Surface. "Oh, where are those three rogue physicians, those monsters? They can't cure me." Off with their heads. So Surface said, King said here, Hair King said, where are those three Rogu physicians? Rogu means rascals, scoundrels, who are not good in the sense. Okay, now, so he asked for those physicians and he said that nobody can cure me, go and kill them. Now Ralph come, one is terribly poor but studious and has never had time to grow fat, the other had never had trouble with his patients. If they recovered, they paid him well, if they died, they highest paid him double. So, Sophie said, that sounds very interesting, send them in. Ralph came and he has explained about another doctor. So Surface was very much feel that it is so interesting. So he said, okay, go and call him inside. The physicians, Dr. Tooley and Dr. Sharp enter. Now Dr. Tooley came inside and he said, long live your highness. Or Dr. Sharp also said the same. Long life to you, your majesty. Now King is saying, oh, stuff and nonsense. We'll see how long I live. I know I have got the most. Long live your highness and long life to you, your majesty. First diagnose what it is. I don't want to look a fool for imagining things. So he's like, don't say such kind of fool things to me. First diagnose me and cure me. So then Dr. Tooley said, okay, well, your highness, we must examine the royal physique. Let me start with the eyes. Now he started examining the king. First he start with the eyes and he said, all well here. Now the pulse, and then he checked the pulse and he said, oh, all well here too. Now the lungs and the back, oh, what's this? A hair, the sound of heartbeat and robust lung. Your majesty, I'm so pleased to diagnose that you are healthy as a fat in yearling, as fit as fiddle. So he checked and he diagnosed all those, and what he said, that now you're very much fit. You do not have any kind of disease. Robust means strong and healthy. Yearling is an animal, especially a horse, between 1 or 2 years old. And fiddle, here it is violin. Okay. So surface turned red and he got angry. Really? Guards, take this Rogu and hang him from the tower wall till the vultures pick his bone clean. And again he gave the command to kill him also. Why? Because he said that he is completely fine. So if somebody said that he hasn't got any disease, king, kill that person. And now Dr. Sharp turned and he has seen all the scenario. So he said, oh, royal highness, let me not delay in diagnosing your ailment, for I fear it is far more serious than I had previously imagined. So he said, okay, royal highness, now it's my turn, and I feel that you are seriously ill. Unfortunately, my colleague could not see the symptoms clearly, and he said, cause my colleague means doctor, physician, or doctor Sharp, or doctor, what was another doctor name? Okay, Dr. Ralph could not see the symptoms clearly. You see, I'm not ordinary physician. I'm specialization in strange, incurable diseases like you seem to have. Let me examine the royal eyes and tongue. Again, he also examined all those and he said that I am specialization in such kind of disease. Or I know that you have very serious disease. So he looks into the king's eyes, right eye, then left eye, and then turn the king's head in every direction possible to examine the tongue. Just as I thought. Now, your majesty, please show me your right hand. Or after seeing all those, and he said, okay, this is the same what I thought. Now, show me your right hand. He bends down to take a pen from his bag and prepares to prick the king's finger for a sample of blood. He quickly pricks the king's right forefinger. And what he did, he take out a pen from his bag and he just pricked the king's finger for taking out the blood. A sample of blood. Okay, so surface, stop it. I tell you, do you want to kill me before I die a natural death for the disease? So he starts shouting, or like kids, he started shouting, what are you doing? It's paining me a lot. And what are you trying to do? You trying to kill me? Dr. Sharp, oh no, your majesty, that was necessary. You have the rarest of rare disease, and I need to make a careful study of royal blood for a perfect cure. So Dr. Sharp said, no, I don't want that. I just want to take a sample of your blood so that I can examine it for the disease. So Dr. Sharp carefully plans his next move, as he does not want to suffer the same fate as Dr. Tully. He just saying all those words very carefully, cause he know if he said that King has no sick, means no disease, or he is completely fine, so he will, King will kill Dr. Sharp too. So he quickly put the drop of blood under the microscope. He looks through the eyepiece for a while and then turns to the King with a very serious expression on his face. Your Majesty, the situation is indeed serious. However, all is not lost. There is only one cure for this type of disease. So he just make a plan, and he said, now you are very much serious, but I have one cure for this disease. So he stopped and then he said, Royal Highness will have to sleep for 3 nights in the shirt of a happy man. What he said? That King have to sleep for 3 nights in a happy shirt man. Or a happy man shirt. Sorry. So what King has to do? King has to sleep for 3 nights in the shirt of a happy man. Means he someone's who used to be very happy, or who is happy, he has to wear the same shirt. If your majesty does not follow this prescription, then we'll have to look for a successor to your throne. And again with that he said, if you will not do this, so you have to, you means nobody will save you for that. Surface, never, no, not ever. Courtiers, ride in all directions and find a happy man and get me his shirt. So he gave the directions to the courtiers, go and bring that shirt for me. I'll get well again. So he's saying, I just want to get well again. I'll send all the soldiers to find the shirt, bring that shirt, and our head will roll. So King only know the one thing, do that work, otherwise I'll kill you. Although the relief the King's man ride, but they find no happy man. Many they see and many they speak, but they can find no happy man. Each day to the expectant King, his man returns sad and empty-handed, and speak of the human woes they witnessed wherever they landed. Woes means sufferings or troubles. Now King's courtiers and everybody has tried to find a happy man, but they couldn't find a single one. Here, Roger and Billy, two courtiers, have been riding for many days. They arrive at a desolate village, and they come across a beggar whistling a merry tune. Here what happened? Roger and Billy, two courtiers, have been riding for many days. So here what they come across a desolate village. Desolate means nobody lived there. Completely isolate means empty. Okay. So there they find a beggar who was whistling in a very merry tune. Or in a happy tune, Roger, looks like we have found just the man we want. So Roger said, I think we find the same man. So Billy said, what's your name, young man? So this young man names, the happy man name is John. And John is a vagabond. Vagabond, I have already told you. Vagabond is a person who have no homes, no means of support, or basically a wanderer. But he asked, gentlemen. So John said, why do you ask? Means what will you do with money? So Roger said, you seem to be in very happy spirit, very good spirit. You're not sad at all? So here Roger is asking that you're not sad, John. Why ever should I be sad? So John said, why should I be sad? I'm too busy enjoying life and all the things that money can buy. I have no time to be sad. So John said, that I don't have time to be sad. I'm just busy in enjoying the life. So Billy said, oh, good fortune. You're just the man we have been looking for. 1,000 gold coins for you, young man. Just give us a shirt you own. So here Billy said, okay, Now Billy was very happy that we find the same man what we are looking for, and now they offered the 1,000 gold coins. 1,000 gold coins for you, young man. Just give us a shirt you own. Means here they are offering 1,000 gold coins to vagabond, to John, and they want what they want. They want his shirt. Vagabond burst out laughing. He laughed so hysterically that Roger and Billy are speechless. Hysterically means in a state of extreme excitement. Why he heard for this tattered, filthy shirt they are giving 1,000 gold coins to me. So he just start laughing, or he burst out laughing. John, 1,000 gold coins, 1,000 gold coins. Indeed, if only I had a shirt to call my own, all I can give you is this. I have no use for your coins. You can keep them. So John said, you want my shirt, you can keep it without coins. You just keep it. I have no use for these coins. Saying this, he hand them a tattered, filthy fragment of a shirt. Now, Roger, I'll take that, friend. Thank you for your kindness. Will be reported to the highness. Billy, come on, let us hurry to the palace. So Roger said, okay, thank you so much, and we'll tell the same thing that you hasn't accepted the gold coins, and we'll tell this thing to king also. And they went to the palace in hurry. Roger and Billy and other courtiers assembled before the king to present him the shirt of the happy man, but the king shrinks back in disgust at the sight of the torn piece of cloth. Now here what he see, he saw a tattered, filthy, torn shirt, a piece of cloth. So he feel like, oh, I need to sit or I need to sleep in the same shirt. He is told about the happy man who gave a piece of shirt but would not take the king's gold because he did not need it. So they both, Rogers and Billy, they both said the same, that he has given the shirt without even accepting the money. He wanted to enjoy life and all the things that money cannot buy. Chorus. Then the king realizes his useful life and his sickness hedged in gloom. Hedged means produced or invented, and gloom means darkness or isolation. He opens his heart and lets in the air of kindness into the room, and out he goes into the world and works in his own chosen line. Blessings are showered, the land is glad, and the king is well and fine. This is adapted from the enchanted short, which was written by John Hay. John Hay was an American statesman, diplomat, author, journalist, and private secretary, and assistant to Abraham Lincoln, the President of the United States. He developed an interest in poetry while studying at Brown University and was named class poet. So kids, read it one more time so that you can understand the play better than that. Thank you so much.